सदाशिवसमारंभां शंकराचार्यमध्यमास्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरंपरां श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वन्दे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनो भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्त्यशान्त्यशान्तिः। यो ब्रह्मणुजाति पूर्वं वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्भदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्त्यशान्त्यशान्तिः। आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनम् आपूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। Something wrong with my laptop. Just give me a moment. Okay, so we looked at the sutra 3419 and also 3420, the sutra artha. To the Purva Pakshi, the answer was given, Siddhantastu. The entire earlier set of sutras was Purva Paksha. In the beginning itself there was Purva Paksha. What was established was the Jnana's Swatantriyam. The Jnana is Swatantra Pramana for Moksha. This was established, and then there was a set of objections we had seen, and then in the 18th sutra we had seen that the Trayo Dharma Skanda was quoted by the Siddhanti to establish Swatantra of Jnana, and in the context Trayo Dharma Skanda also showed the Sannyasa Ashrama. So the Purva Pakshi asked as to what is a Pramana for Sannyasa Ashrama itself. He says Paramarsham Jaimir Achodana cha Apavadatihi. He said that it is an Anuvada, as in there is only a restatement of what is being followed or seen elsewhere, and thereby there is no vidhi at all in sannyasa here. As to the brahmacharya, grihastha and vanaprastha, anuvada is there, paramarsham is anuvada, and therefore there is achodana, says the Jaimini Acharya, who is Purva Mimamsaka. He says achodana, there is no vidhi here, and cha apavadatihi, shruti itself says by yavat shruti, yavat jivam ityadi, thereby, so for example he has given virahava esha devanam yogni udvasayate. So one who gives up the agni is viraha or putraha, that kind of meaning is there. So agni should not be given up, mean karma should not be given up, whereas the fourth ashrama, you the siddhanti who is trying to establish, that means agni udvasana, and that is not allowed by the shruti. And siddhanta we had seen, siddhantastu anushtayam badarayana samya shruti. He said that anushtayam badarana acharya, Vyasacharya says that the parivrajyam is anushtayam, the sannyasa ashrama anushtana should be done. Why Samya Shruti? If at all there is Paramarsha of the earlier three ashramas and they are the only three ashramas, it cannot be so, because the fourth also there is an Anuvada by Brahma Samstha Amrutattva Meeti said the Siddhanti. Then Yadva, otherwise Anushtayam, meaning there is no Vidhi as per the Purva Pakshi. Siddhanti says, okay, let there not be Vidhi, but there is definitely fourth ashrama in the 19th sutra. In the 20th sutra, yadva, or what, or it is vidhi, definitely a vidhi, vidhir va dharanavat. So he said vidhi va, vidhi va dharanavat, like the dharana in Purva Mimamsa sutras, it has been analyzed that there can be vakya bheda. Because there is Vakya Bheda in the त्रयो धर्मस्कंद इत्यादि ते सर्वे पुण्यलोकाः भवन्ति एंड इन दी एंड सिद्धांत सेड दैट ब्रह्म संस्था अमृतत्वमिति इज अ संन्यास विधि. नाउ इफ दैट इज अ संन्यास विधि देन इन अ सिंगल सेंटेंस देर आर मल्टीपल थिंग्स गिवन देयर फॉर देर बी वाक्य भेद सेट दी पूर्वपक्षी एंड दैट इज अ दोष. टू दैट द सिद्धांत रिप्लाइज दैट इट कैन स्टिल बी अ विधि लाइक धारणा धारणा फॉर अपर कार्य एंड फॉर देव कार्य वेर शुड बी दी समित बी प्लेस्ड ऑन दी सृगदंड वेदर अबो और बिलो. इट शुड बी बिलो फॉर अपर कर्म इट शुड बी अबो फॉर देव कार्य. इट इज गिवन इन अ सिंगल वाक्य ऑल दो देर इज एक वाक्यता एज सीन बाय ऑन द फेस वैल्यू देर सीम्स टू बी एक वाक्यता बट स्टिल देर इज इष्टापत्तीन वाक्य भेद ऑल्सो बिकॉज इन देव कार्य समित शुड बी कैरिड अबो दि सरगदंड फॉर दैट देर इज नो अदर प्लेस दैट देर इज नो मेन्शन एनीवेयर एल्स देर फोर अपूर्वत्वाद दिस इज अपूर्व एंड इट इज फाउंड इन दिस सेंटेंस देर फोर बींग अपूर्व बींग अनोन इफ द श्रुति रिवील्स इट इन अ सिंगल सेंटेंस इवन इफ इट रिवील्स मल्टीपल थिंग्स इफ देर आर मल्टीपल विधिज ऑल्सो वाक्य भेद इज इष्टा देर इट इज डिजायरेबल देर इज नो दोषा देर because otherwise we will not know as to how this deva karya should be done where should the samit be placed for deva karya. So that is being quoted by the siddhanti that is dharanavata. Va is optional interpretation and this is how vivarana also sees it. Siddhanta sees it in this manner as to there is a sannyasa vidhi also asmin vakye ashramanam vidhireva. In this statement, Trayo Dharma Skanda, there is Vidhi of Ashramas. Na Anuvada, it is not Paramarsha, it is not an Anuvada. Nacha, now if the Siddhanti is being objected to by the Purvapakshi, Nacha Aneka Ashrama Vidhani Vakya Vedasya iti Sampratam. If at all there is an objection as to Aneka Ashrama Vidhani in a single sentence, if there is, there are four Ashrama Vidhis, then वाक्य भेद सैदी न सांप्रतम दिस इज नॉट अ वैलिड ऑब्जेक्शन इफ यू से दैट ओ ब्रह्मचर्य गृहस्थ देन वानप्रस्थ एंड सन्यास ऑल फोर आर ऑर्डेन इन द सेम सेंटेंस देर इज वाक्य भेद वन वाक्य शुड बी डूइंग वन जॉब नॉट मल्टीपल जॉब्स दिस इज मीमांसा शास्त्र इफ एट ऑल इट इज गिविंग फोर डिफरेंट आश्रम विधिज देन देर इज वाक्य भेद This objection is not valid, says the Siddhanti. Why? Apurvatvena ashramanam videhe eva avashyakatvena vakya bhedasya ishtatvat. Since the ashramas are apurva, unknown, earlier to this vakya, therefore ashramanam videhe eva, the vidhi itself is ishta. Vakya bheda is ishta for vidhi. Vidhi being unknown for the vidhi of ashramas, आवश्यकत्वेन डेफिनेटली देर शुड देर इज वाक्य भेद वी एग्री दिस देर इज वाक्य भेद एंड दैट वाक्य भेद इज इष्ट वाक्य भेद से इष्टत्वात् अदरवाइज वी वुडंट नो एज टू देर आर फोर आश्रमास विच शुड बी फॉलोड. नाउ इन दी त्रयोधर्म स्कंद इटसेल्फ एक वाक्यता प्रतीतावपि अपूर्वार्थविदो दृष्टांता. What is the example for Vakya Bheda being Ishta in Puro Mimamsa also? Siddhanti gives the example from Karmakanda itself. Eka Vakyata Pratita Vapi. Although there is Pratiti of Eka Vakyata in this Trayodharma Skandaha Shruti, similarly there is Pratiti of Eka Vakyata in Dharana Vidhi also. But there is Vakya Bheda. For that, Apurvartha Vidhav Drishtanta. In the vidhi, which is apurva, there is vakya bheda. Although it appears as a single vakya, there should be another vakya imagined there. There should be a kalpana done of a vidhi, just like dharana how? Adastat samidham dharayan anudraved uparihi deve bhyo dharayati ityatra sragdandad adastat samidharana vidhyeka vakyata pratita vapi उपरी धारण से अपूर्वत्वाद एक वाक्यता भंगेन विधि यथा कल्पिता तथा इह अपि इत्यर्थः. जस्ट लाइक इन धारण विधि देर इज एन अपियरेंस ऑफ एक वाक्यता बट देर इज वाक्य भेदा एंड दैट वाक्य भेदा इज नॉट अ दोषा इट इज इष्टा बिकॉज दी उपर धारण विधि उपरी धारण विधि इज अप्राप्त इट इज अप्राप्त मीनिंग इट इज अपूर्व इट इज नॉट नोन अंटिल देन सो इन द अपर कार इट इज मेंशन अधस्तात समिदम धारयन अनुद्रवेद वन शुड वॉक विद दी अनु दिस द्रव धातु इज गत्यर्थ का सो अनुद्रवेद वन शुड फॉलो और वॉक अधस्तात समिदम धारयन धारयन इज शत्रुंता सो होल्डिंग दी समित वेर अधस्तात बिलो दि सृग्दंड इन दी अपर कार्य उपरी ही देवेभ्यो धारयति वेर एज हियर देर इज नो विधि धारयति इज जस्ट अ मेंशन धारयन अनुद्रवेत अनुद्रवेत इज अ विधिलिंग बट धारयति इज अ लट लकार सो इट इज जस्ट अ स्टेटमेंट उपरी ही देवेभ्यो धारयति फॉर दी देवताज उपरी धारयति किम धारयति समिदम धारयति सो व्हाई डज दैट श्रुति मेंशन देवाज एट ऑल देर इज नो कॉन्टेक्स्ट फॉर देवताज देर इन दी अपर कार्य इत्यत्र सृग्दंड सृग्दंडाद अधस्तात समिधारण विध्येक वाक्यता प्रतीतावपि ऑल्दो देर इज समिधारण विधि हियर इन अपर कार्य एज टू समित शुड बी हेल्ड बिलो दी सृग्दंड एकवाक्यता प्रतीति इज देर बट स्टिल अपि उपरि धारणस्य अपूर्वत्वाद इन दी देव कार्य दी समित शुड बी हेल्ड अबो दी सृग्दंड फॉर दैट देर इज नो अदर प्रमाण दिस इज द ओनली प्रमाण देर फोर एक वाक्यता भंगेन दिस वन वाक्य ऑल दो इट अपियर्स टू बी सिंगल वाक्य इट शुड बी डिवाइडेड एंड विधि यथा कल्पिता देर इज अ विधि इमेजिन इन धारेत धारयेत देवेभ्यो समिधम उपरी धारयेत सृग्दंडाद उपरी धारयेत दिस इज द विधि विच कल्पना हैज टू बी डन विधि कल्पना हैज टू बी डन तथा यह अपि यह अपि मीनिंग इन दी त्रयो धर्म स्कंधा श्रुति ऑल्सो नाउ दिस इज दिस सिद्धांति गिविंग द आंसर बेस्ड ऑन वॉट द पूर्व पक्षी हैज ऑब्जेक्टेड टू सो समाधान इज डन टू मेक दिस पूर्व पक्षी एग्रीएबल सो वॉट वॉट प्रोसेस हैज बीन फॉलोड बाई दी सिद्धांति इज दैट फर्स्ट ही सेड दैट ओके लेट इट बी अनुवाद ऑफ आश्रम सो देर इज अनुवाद ऑफ दी संन्यास आश्रम ऑल्सो विच मीन्स दैट देर इज संन्यास आश्रम सो दैट हैज बीन एस्टैब्लिश इन दी 19 सूत्र बाय साम्य श्रुते सिंस द परामर्श इज देर फॉर द अर्लियर थ्री फॉर द फोर्थ ऑल्सो लेट देर बी परामर्श अनुवाद देन ही सेज इट्स अ विधि संन्यास इज नॉट अ मियर अनुवाद देर संन्यास विधि इज देर जस्ट लाइक दी अदर थ्री ऑल्सो देर इज नो अनुवाद अदर थ्री आश्रम विधीज आर देर इन ए सिंगल वाक्य इटसेल्फ वेर दी वाक्य भेद इज इष्ट बाय कोटिंग धारण श्रुति समित धारण श्रुति नाउ सिद्धांती कम्स टू दी परम सिद्धांत वॉट इज द रियल सिद्धांत वॉट इज द रियल अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ दिस त्रयोधर्म स्कंद मंत्र देर दि सिद्धांति से वस्तु तस्तु इन रियालिटी अस्मिन् वाक्ये पारिव्राज्यमेव विधीयते इन दि त्रयोधर्म स्कंद एंडिंग विथ ब्रह्म संस्था अमृतत्वमेति ओनली पारिव्राज्य संन्यास आश्रम विधि अलोन इज देर देर इज नो विधि फॉर द अदर थ्री संन्यास आश्रम विधि वाक्य इज वॉट दिस मंत्र स्टैंड फॉर हाउ सो आश्रमत्रयम् अनूद्य अनित्य फलत्वेन तन्निंदया ब्रह्म संस्तत्वस्येव नित्य फलत्वेन स्तूयमानत्वात् सिद्धांती गिव्स द हेतु एज टू व्हाई देर इज ओनली संन्यास आश्रम विधि देर एंड नॉट द विधि फॉर द अदर थ्री आश्रमास बिकॉज अदर थ्री आश्रमास आर नोन फ्रॉम सेपरेट श्रुतिस सो आश्रमत्रयम् अनूद्य थ्री आश्रमास आर ऑलरेडी प्राप्त विच आर ऑलरेडी नोन टू द पूर्व पक्षी ऑल्सो बाय वॉट मीन्स डज ही नो ही नोज बिकॉज ही हैज सेड दीज थ्री आर अनुवादास दैट इज द स्टेटमेंट मेड बाय द पूर्व पक्षी सो इट इज वेल नोन टू द पूर्व पक्षी एज टू देर बीइंग थ्री आश्रमास If and he does not know there is a fourth ashrama, he does not agree also there is a fourth ashrama. In that case, the three ashrama vidhis are prapta elsewhere. And it is an anuvada. Or it is anuvada of what is already known through other dharma shastras, not through shruti. और थ्रू आचरण ऑल्सो। सो ब्रह्मचर्या, गृहस्थ एंड वानप्रस्थ इज नोन बाय प्रत्यक्ष प्रमाण, वन नोज दैट बाय संप्रदाय, वन नोज दैट इन दैट केस द श्रुति इज जस्ट गिविंग एन अनुवादा दैट सच थ्री आश्रमास विच आर वेल नोन डू एग्जिस्ट। ओके दे डू एग्जिस्ट, सो इट इज नॉट अ विधि। सो आश्रमत्रयम् अनूद्य अनित्य फलत्वेन तन्निन्दया, देर इज अनित्य फल। वाई इज इट अनित्य फल? वाई आर दीज थ्री आश्रमास गोइंग टू लीड टू ओनली अनित्य फल? हाउ डू वी नो? बिकॉज इट सेज दैट ते सर्वे पुण्यलोकाः भवन्ति इन द सेम वाक्य। ऑल ऑफ दीज बिलोंगिंग टू द फर्स्ट थ्री आश्रमास बिकम पुण्यलोका। सॉरी देयर इज अ पॉप अप ऑफ दिस, आई थिंक या द पीसी हैज स्लोड डाउन बिकॉज विंडोज इज डूइंग सम अपडेट। एंड देयर बाय द फर्स्ट थ्री आश्रमास अनुद्य हैविंग, अनुद्य इज लेबंत, सो हैविंग रीस्टेटेड वॉट इज ऑलरेडी प्राप्त बाय अदर मीन्स, देन श्रुति सेज दैट देर इज अनित्य फल बिकॉज पुण्यलोकाः भवन्ति मीन्स दैट देर कैन बी प्राप्ति ऑफ अप टू हिरण्यलोक, हिरण्यगर्भलोक, हिरण्यगर्भ पदवी। देर कैन बी देवलोक प्राप्ति बाय उपासना, देर कैन बी पितृलोक प्राप्ति बाय कर्म, देर कैन बी हिरण्यलोक प्राप्ति, हिरण्यगर्भ तादात्म्य संबंध प्राप्ति, ब्रह्मलोक प्राप्ति वाया उपासना एंड ऑल्सो समुच्चय विथ कर्म विच वी हैड सीन अर्लियर। बट दे ऑल विल कम बैक, ऑल ऑफ दीज उपासकाज एज वेल एज कर्मीज विल हैव पुनर्जन्म। देयरफॉर हाउएवर लॉन्ग इज द सुख भोग इन स्वर्ग इत्यादि स्टिल अनित्य फल इट इज। एंड देयर बाय तन्निंदया ब्रह्म संस्थत्वस्य एव नित्य फलत्वेन स्तूयमानत्वात्। ब्रह्म संस्था अमृतत्वमिति, एंड दैट अमृतत्वम इज मुख्य अमृतत्व, नॉट आपेक्षिक। देयरफॉर इफ द ब्रह्म संस्था अटेन्स अमृतत्व एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी एस्टैब्लिश्ड दैट पारिव्राज्य विधि इज देयर इन दैट वाक्य, देन द सन्यासी अलोन विल हैव ब्रह्म संस्थत्वम, ब्रह्मणि सम्यक् स्थितिः। एंड देयर बाय देयर इज निंदा ऑफ द अदर्स एज हैविंग अनित्य फल, वेर एज द पारिव्राज्य आश्रम अलोन विल हैव नित्य फल। सो नित्य फलत्वेन स्तूयमानत्वात्। एंड इफ देयर इज प्रेज ऑफ अ पर्टिकुलर थिंग देन दैट इज अ विधि, दिस इज एग्रीड टू बाय द पूर्वमीमांसका, यत् स्तूयते तद् विधेयम् इति न्यायात्। बिकॉज देर इज अ न्याय एज टू वॉट एवर इज प्रेस, देर इज अ विधि इन दैट प्रेस, हिडन इन दैट प्रेस, वॉट एवर इज प्रेस यत् स्तूयते तद् विधेयम्, तद् विधीयते। इफ द ब्रह्म संस्था इज अटेन्ड बाय sannyasi, then sannyasa vidhi is there because there is a praise of sannyasi attaining brahma samstam and amrutattvam thereby. Vaya brahma samstha is sannyasi, and brahma, who is brahma samstha? That is sannyasi, and brahma samstha will attain amrutattvam, meaning sannyasi will attain amrutattvam. If sannyasi attains amrutattvam, then sannyasa vidhi is there. This is how sannyasa is the only vidhi there, whereas the others are what? Anuvada. Other ashrama, anuvada is there. Nacha brahma samstatvasya grahastadinam sambhavaditi sampratam. Purvapakshi says that, why should you think that brahma samstha shabda applies only to the sannyasa ashrama? Just a clarification here, I wanted to make this. Srugdanda is basically it's a danda which is covering the pot which carries purodhasha for the devatas. So there it should be kept on the top. In the preta karma, the samhita is opposite, it's kept below. So An example is given, just like a broken mirror is used only in Preta Karma, some example is given. So it is opposite to the Devakarya. So Srigdanda is basically it's a ladle which is used to cover the, not exactly cover, but it is kept on, the pot is covered and then the samid is carried on top of the ladle there. So that's the scenario there. Okay, so Purvapakshi now says that you cannot make an assumption that only sannyasi will attain Brahma Samstha. Amrutattvam is for a Brahma Samstha. That Brahma Samstha is a sannyasi, that is not agreeable to. Why? Because we don't agree to it, because in other three ashram also Brahma Samstattvam is possible. And they will also attain Amrutattvam in that case. Why would you limit it only to a sannyasi? Nacha Brahma Samstattvasya grihastadinam sambhavad iti sampratam. For grihastha ityadi, for the other three ashramas, Brahma Samstattvam, especially grihastadi is mentioned. So grihastha and vanaprastha, who have lot of karma and upasana to be done. Therefore, Brahma Samstha being possible in grihastha, ashrama ityadi is an objection that is not valid. Sambhavad iti na sampratam. That na should be read here, na sampratam. Why? Siddhanti says, tesham swasva karmasaktataya brahma samstattva ayogat. Because there is a lot of karma to be done, there is a lot of responsibility there, and thereby it is not possible to remain in brahma samyak sthitihi. Nishtha is not possible. And thereby, swasva karma, all these ashramas have their own karma, whereas sannyasi is the only one who does not have swakarma because of karma tyaga being done by the sannyasi, and thereby Brahma samstattvam is applicable only to a sannyasi, says the Siddhanti. Parishishyamana parivradeva, parivrajya vidhi has been shown, and that Parivrat, sannyasi alone is Parishishyamana, is the only one who remains after the three ashramas who have karmas. Fourth one remaining who does not have a karma can have Brahma Samstha, that is a Parivrat. Parivrat eva Brahma Samstha ityasmin pakshena vakya bhedaha. There is no vakya bheda also. That vakya bheda is ishta, and now that vakya bheda itself is taken away, so there can be no dosha also, and we don't need a dharana vidhi comparison also, because there is no vakya bheda. There is vidhi not of four ashramas, there is vidhi only of one ashrama. So Brahma Samstha is Parivrat, and other three ashramas, anuvadas, have been done, and Brahma Samstha being sannyasi, that Brahma Samstattvam is praised as Amrutattvam eti. Brahma Samstha gains Amrutattvam, therefore Stuyamanatvad vidhi, sannyasa vidhi, and sannyasa is the only vidhi, therefore there is absolutely no vakya bheda also. Tasma sarva karma parityag lakshanasya parivrajyasya pramanikatvad vidyayaha swatantra purushartha sadhanatvam yuktam iti siddham. So Siddhanti closes his argument saying that what has been established in the beginning in the first adhikarana of the fourth pada of the third chapter, that is swatantra purushartha siddhi of the jnana, it leads to moksha independently without being subsidiary to karma. And now who attains this moksha jnana? That is one who is in the parivrajya ashrama, which has been shown as a vidhi by trayo dharmaskanda ityadi pramanikatvad, because Parivrad, the sannyasa ashrama, is having pramana in Shruti, therefore tasma sarva karma parityaga lakshanasya parivrajyasya, of that sannyasa parivrajya, which is characterized by what? Sarva karma parityaga, giving up all karmas, and thereby there being a pramana, pramanikatvad vidyaya swatantra purushartha sadhanatvam yuktam iti siddham. Vidya, which leads to sannyasa, meaning vidvat sannyasa, or vidya, which comes up after sannyasa, which is vividisha sannyasa, ending with amrutatvam, because of Brahma Samsatvam. That Brahma Samsatvam is possible only in Sannyasa Ashrama. Jnana may be possible in other ashramas, but Nishtha is not possible, has been shown by the Siddhanti, and thereby Vidya is Svatantra to Moksha Purusharta, and there is also Parivrajya Vidhi. Iti Siddham. This has been established, and the Adhikarana comes to an end here. पूर्व यथा अनुष्ठेय आश्रम साम्य श्रुते पारिव्राज्यस्य अनुष्ठेयत्वं प्रतिष्ठापितं तद्वत् इयमेव जुहूर आदित्यः इत्यादि कर्मांग स्तुत्या रसतमत्वादि वाक्यस्य साम्यात् स्तुतिमात्रत्वमिति दृष्टांत संगत्य इदमः दि स्तुतिमात्र अधिकरणं कम्स अप विद पूर्वपक्ष बाय दि कंपैरिजन दृष्टांत संगति देयर इज अ कंपैरिजन विद दि अर्लियर अधिकरण व्हाटएवर methodology has been followed by the Siddhanti, same is being taken up by the Purvapakshi as to Purvam Yatha Anushtheya Ashrama Samya Shrute. Because of similarity of following a particular ashrama, which ashrama? Sannyasa Ashrama. That is similar to which other three ashramas? As quoted by the Purvapakshi, Brahmacharya Ityadi. So Anushtheya Ashrama Samya Shrute. Because of the Samya Shruti, of sannyasa also being similarly being recommended to practice as the other three ashramas, thereby what? Parivrajasya anushtheyatvam pratishtapitam. Sannyasa also was established. This was in the 18th sutra, not as a vidhi, but anushtheyam. Fourth ashram was established. Tadvat iyameva juhur adityaha. This juhu itself is surya. There is such a mantra. Ityadi karmanga stutya. There is a karmanga stuti there because juhur is karmanga, and that juhu being karmanga is praised as aditya. So there is a karmanga stuti, stuti of juhu, which is karmanga. So ityadi karmanga stutya rasatamatva adi vakyasya samyat. Rasatamatva is also stuti elsewhere. So rasatamatva adi are rasatama, tama pratyaya has been used. The best, it is a superlative degree. So rasatama, best of the rasas, that kind of a stuti is being done. Ityadi vakyasya samyat, rasatamatvadi vakyasya samyat, there is a similarity there. So karmanga stuti is there in iyam eva juhur. This juhu itself is aditya. Juhu is trilinga, so iyam eva juhu is aditya. Aditya comparison is for stuti, stuti of juhu. And juhu is karmanga, therefore karmanga stuti has taken place there, and there is a similarity to this stuti elsewhere as to rasatamatvadi gunas are mentioned. These gunas are not real, they are meaning they are not upasya gunas, says the Purvapakshi. There is similarity of stuti, therefore what stuti matratvam iti drishtanta sangatya idam. There is only stuti, there is no vidhi there, there is no guna vidhi there, says the Purvapakshi, and thereby Stuti Matradhikaranam comes up, and this sutra there, 21st sutra, is Stuti Matram Upadana Diti Chenna Apurva Diti Chenna Purvatva Stuti Matram Upadana Diti Chenna Purvatva Stuti Matram Upadana Diti Chenna Purvatva. So the sutra should not be having Padacheda. So I just chanted it again. So Stuti Matram Paratvat has been the claim. Stuti Matra Paratvam is there of that Vakya. So the sutra says Stuti Matram. The Rasatamatvadi Vakya has Stuti Matram. Why so? He says that Upadanat. Because of Upadana. As to first the Padachya Stuti Matram Upadanat Iti Chet Na Apurvatvat. So, stuti matram, it is a mere stuti. Why so? Upadanat iti chet is the purvapaksha, and then na apurvatvat is the siddhanta. Because upadanat is the hetu. Because of the reference to the upadana, reference to the we'll see in the statement when we'll see as to what is the comparison being done there. The angas of the karma are being mentioned there because of upadana, because of a reference. What reference? The reference to upadana of what? Of the angas. Anga reference is being done in that vakya. And therefore, if you look at it, there is a stuti, similarity of stuti. Why should it be seen as a guna? Guna of upasya is the objection by the Purvapakshi. Iti chet, Siddhanti says na, it is not stuti matra. Why? Apurvatva. Because it is not seen elsewhere. It is this guna of how the upasana should be done, the upasya, those gunas are not seen elsewhere. Therefore, apurvatva, this will become a vidhi, says the Siddhanti. Atra Purvapakshe karma, there is a typo there, just give me a moment there. Purvapakshe karmanga, it should be karmanga ashrita upasthinam. So there is a typo here. Yeah, atra Purvapakshe karmanga ashrita, this anga karmanga ashrita upasthinam anushthana asiddhihi. Purvapakshi says that karma anga ashrita upasanas. There it is not an upasana anushthana vidhi at all. Anushthana asiddhi. Siddhante tatsiddhir. Tatsiddhir meaning anushthana siddhi iti phalabheda. Siddhanti says that there is a karma anga upasana anushthana vidhi there. Where udghita, here also there is a typo. Udgitadi, it's not you here, it is Udgitadyupasi. So Udgitadi upasthishu, so Udgitadyupasthishu shruyate. So this is dyu, not you, dyu. So Udgitadyupasthishu shruyate. What is the shravana, what is the vakya there, shruti there? Sa esha rasanam rasatamah paramaha ityadi. So chandogya 113 states sa eshaha rasanam rasatamah paramaha. This udgita is rasanam rasatamah. Among all rasas, it is the best of the rasas. So is the rasa is the essence. So among all the essences, this is the best of the essence. Meaning what? It is the quintessence of all essences. So this udgita is praise, says the Purvapakshi there, ityadi. Tadvakyam kim karmanga udgita stuti matra param. Is it only praising the karmanga? Because udgita is a karmanga, udgita is a part of the sama, which is anga to the karma. So this udgita, which should be seen, udgitam upasita. So there udgita upasana, is it there or tadvakyam kim karmanga udgita stuti matram? Is it just a stuti of the udgita which is anga to the karma? Uta udgita upasta guna vidhayakam iti vishaye. Or in the udgita upasana there is a guna vidhi. What is a guna vidhi? Look at this udgita in the upasana, the upasya is udgita, and look upon this udgita as rasanam rasatamaha. Siddhanti says that it is a guna vidhi. When such a vishaye sati samshaya comes up, rasatamatvadi vakyam sarvamapi karmanga udgita stuti matra param. Purvapakshi says that it is only all these gunas that you are seeing are not gunas of the upasya. They are only a praise for the udgita, which is karmanga. Kutaha, why so? Karmanga udgita adyupadana shravanad iti ched iti purvapaksha. Why? Because he says karmanga udgita adi upadana shravanad. There is a shravana of what? The anga, which is udgita. That udgita is upadana, is there is a reference of the udgita there, which is part of the karma. Therefore, karmanga udgita adi upadana shravana. That upadana is what? It is just a part of the karma. And being an anga, if the anga is mentioned, then it should be just a praise, just like what? Just like the yupa or the Upa is praise, sometimes Juhu is praise. So the praise of the Karmanga is not a vidhi, says the Purvapakshi. So he says that Karmanga Udgita Adyupadana Shravanaditi Ched iti Purvapaksha. Siddhantastu, whereas Siddhanta is na stuti matram. Na. That na is what? Kinna stuti matram nasti ityartha. It is not stuti matra. It is not mere stuti. Apitu guna vidayakam. There is a upasya guna which is being talked about. And since this guna is not known earlier, kutaha apurvatva. Since it is not known, upasana has been established. But you don't know in which gunas the Udgita is upasya. And definitely we do not know that adityatvam or adityatvam elsewhere. If it is in upasana, see adityatva comparison with the juhu, there is no upasana there. Juhu, yameva juhu aditya, there is no upasana established. Had there been an upasana, then adityatvam would have been the guna of the upasya. So the comparison is not valid because yameva juhur aditya, that is a stuti all right because there is no upasana at all there. But here upasana is there. And in the first mantra itself the upasana has been established. And having established the upasana, then what follows is not a stuti, it is a guna. Because once the upasana vidhi is prapta, mukhya vidhi, then the, which is called as the, meaning unknown, prior unknown. But if the upasana is known, then what is known later is a guna vidhi. Therefore, this will become a guna to the upasana which is established in the earlier vakyas. So siddhantastu nastuti matra apito guna vidayakam kutaha apurvatvat. Kasya apurvatvat upasanasya na. Upasana is already prapta. So kasya apurvatvam gunasya. So upasya guna is apurva. So far we didn't know that there should be rasatamatvadi drishti in the upasya udgita. And thereby karmanga udgita upasyinam rasatamatvadi gunanam cha. Manantara apraptatvat, since there is no other pramana for rasatamatvadi guna to be seen in the Udgita upasti ityartaha prakrita eva vidhi sambhave prakranantara udgita adi stuti lakshana kalpana shruti lakshana stuti lakshana kalpanam anyayataram iti bhavaha. Siddhanti gives a further reasoning as to why should there be no comparison to something elsewhere and call this as a stuti. Because here prakriti eva, in the context itself, in the prakruta itself, vidhi sambhave. Since the mukhya vidhi is prapta, upasana vidhi. Now having known that there is an upasana in Udgita, then gunavidhi sambhave. Gunavidhi is possible. If the gunavidhi is possible, then prakranantara, going across prakranas, and prakranantara udgita adi stuti lakshana kalpanam. Imagining something which is characterized as a stuti, as a praise, in a different prakrana of the udgita, that is anyayam, anyayataram. It is not only anyayam, it is anyayataram. It is more improper than, you know, than what Purvapakshi has done earlier. So he says that this is anyayataram. It is not only logical, it is not only failing logic, but it is failing logic in a comparative degree. So anyayataram, tarap pratyaya has been used. Iti bhavaha. So this is worse than the earlier logic that you have used to oppose the siddhanta. This is the idea there. So we'll stop here. I'm already late for the next part. We'll continue with the 22nd sutra introduction in the next part. Amrayante samsitam adi madhyanta varjitam ananda ghanam apurnam atme jyoti rupasmehe. Namaste. Dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.